morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports 2024. It's raw. 2024 is uncut. 2024 is filled with action for sure. And as you can see, snow is all up on the floor. New York City getting our first inches of snow in this 2024. It's a cold, cold world. The football world, the soccer world, it's a cold, cold world. And once again, FIFA has decided to give Lionel Messi the men's player of the year ahead of Erling Haaland. The sporting world woke up to the news of the FIFA men's player of the year. Erling Haaland has once again lost to Lionel Messi. And the description and just the way they explained the rationale behind their reasoning doesn't add up. The math is not matting. The psychology is not psychological. Lionel Messi won the Ballon d'Or based on the fact that he won the World Cup in Qatar with Argentina. Erling Haaland missed this one, and the criteria of the FIFA men's was after the World Cup. So Lionel Messi, after the World Cup, came to the US and won the MLS League Cup. And with all due respect, the MLS League Cup in the world of football doesn't match up to the tournaments across board. Erling Haaland recently with Man City has won the Super Cup. So the explanation of why Lionel Messi has won again doesn't make sense. If you go per their own criteria and like the major points that guarantee a player eligibility. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports. It's a cold, cold world. I love Lionel Messi. I think he's an amazing footballer. But I think Erling Haaland has been dealt a bad blow of, should I say, like not being a fan favorite. You can have your favorites, but the facts and the facts of the matter overshadows and climbs over the favorites. Anyways, yes, thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports. It's a cold world. Winter is here, and the Premier League is also still battling it out. Manchester City have found a way to near Liverpool in their splendid performance this weekend against Newcastle. That was an amazing game. I mean, what a great game of football and soccer, where teams are willing to go out and battle it out. Man City is still the team to beat. Arsenal is in need of a striker. Liverpool have lost Mo Salah to the African Cup of Nations, which is going on right about now. Their first game, Egypt played 2-2. Liverpool is missing key players. Would they be able to sustain? Would they be able to maintain the pressure from Man City? Kevin De Bruyne returned with a splendid 30-minute cameo, getting a goal and an assist. I mean, is there any player in the world that has... I'm thinking in my memory of any footballer who is of the level of Kevin De Bruyne, and nobody comes to mind. You could say maybe Andrea Pirlo of the Italian Azzurri, the legendary Pirlo, but even Pirlo was more of a defensive. I mean, Kevin De Bruyne is all and all. And now that he's back with Man City, if Erling Haaland also comes and sprinkles his magic on top, I don't see any team beating Man City. Will Liverpool be able to match up without Mo Salah? Is Darwin Nunes going to rise up to the occasion and take the moment? Because I know that he has what it takes. His movement, his positioning, but his intelligence of the game. Thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports. This is the winter edition. Winter is finally here, and the Premier League is the top four spots. Everybody is key. Newcastle, from how they are projecting, maybe an European tournament like the Europa League will be good for them next year. I don't see them making the top four. Aston Villa is playing amazing football, and Tottenham Hotspur, you cannot count Ange Postecoglou out. Let me know which teams you think are going to finish in the top four this year. I think Liverpool and Man City is a guarantee. Will Chelsea be able to get any European football this year? Chelsea season, I mean, the less I say about Chelsea, the better. They need a striker. Every little kid in London town will tell you, those Chelsea boys can't put the ball in the net. Those Chelsea boys need a striker. So, I mean, That is the only thing Chelsea is lacking. Nicholas Jackson is out to the African tournament as well with Senegal, but Nicholas Jackson is not the answer when it comes to Chelsea's striker solution. Armando Broja, I thought, would have been great. He looked promising at Southampton, but maybe he needs game time. I don't know. He's clearly not it. Let me know what you think about that. Thank you for tuning in to Awesome Sport. This is the winter edition. Snow is finally here. Who do you tip to win the top four? This, like, to be in the top four of the Premier League this season. Which teams are you tipping to finish also in the Europa League contingent spot? This has been Awesome Sports. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for all the love and support. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0. New ASCM music collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This has been Awesome Sports. But the channel coming soon. Over and out.